Welcome back to another episode of Finding God in Film. I feel like everyone has their own handful of nostalgic movies that they just loved as a kid. The movies you didn't mind watching over and over and over again because you could always count on them for a good movie watching experience. My childhood VHS starter pack consisted of a lot of Disney movies, but the ones that I remember loving the most were The Lion King, Hercules, and Mulan. 90s Disney hit different. Now, I've talked about Lion King, and I've also talked about Hercules. So today I decided it's finally time to finish that holy childhood VHS trinity by finding God in Mulan.
Because of our divine nature, we tell the stories that we already know. The story of our Savior and of His plan for us. The one true eternal story.
Quick recap. When the Huns invade China, every Chinese household is expected to send one man to enlist in the military. Afraid for her aging father and feeling out of place in her role in society, Mulan disguises herself as a man, runs away, and takes her father's place in the army. While she struggles at first, she eventually becomes a clever and capable soldier, and even when she is kicked out of the military after they discover that she is a woman, Mulan still risks her life to save the Chinese emperor from the Huns. One of the things I've always loved about Mulan is her determination in the face of adversity. During one of the best musical masterpieces to ever hit the big screen, I'll Make a Man Out of You, Mulan's captain and eventual love interest, Li Sheng, notices Mulan's inability and weakness and tries to send her home, believing her to be an incapable soldier. And at this moment, Mulan could have easily done just that, gone home. She would have been successful in her main goal, which was always to save her dad. But she knew that she had more to offer and wanted to prove herself. So she buckles down and keeps trying, eventually becoming everything the world told her that she never could be, and saving China. She blooms in adversity.
The flower that blooms in adversity is the most rare and beautiful of all.
Life here? Is not meant to be easy. We aren't going to show up to the battlefront already a perfect, capable soldier. This life is hard and full of adversity and struggle, just like Mulan's time in the military. But just as Mulan needed that time to fail and to learn and to grow so that she could eventually become someone capable of saving China, we need to fail and learn and grow in this life so that we can become everything Christ knows that we can be. This earthly life is our divine training montage, and through it, He will make a divine being out of us. For I reckon that the sufferings of this present time are not worthy to be compared with the glory which shall be revealed in us. For our light affliction, which is but for a moment, worketh for us a far more exceeding and eternal weight of glory. Be patient in afflictions, for thou shalt have many, but endure them, for lo, I am with thee, even unto the end of thy days. Throughout this journey, Mulan is trying to figure out who she is. She feels that she has failed to bring her family honor in the way that society expects of her, so instead she tries to bring them honor by fighting in the war.
Maybe I didn't go for my father. Maybe what I really wanted was to prove I could do things right. So when I looked in the mirror, I'd see someone worthwhile.
But even after her incredible success, when Mulan reunites with her dad, he doesn't really care as much about her saving China as he does about just having her home again.
Mulan.
Father, I brought you the sword of Shan Yu and the crest of the Emperor. They're gifts to honor the Fa family.
Thank you.
the greatest gift and honor is having you for a daughter. I've missed you so.
I've missed you too, Baba.
She is already valuable to him simply by being his daughter. While we are definitely sent here to grow and repent and become like Christ, Heavenly Father doesn't need us to prove our worth to him. We already have that intrinsic value and his undying love by simply being his sons and daughters. And it is a love that pure that led him to sacrifice his only begotten son for us. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. And we, like Mulan, also will get the opportunity to reunite with our Heavenly Father. And I just know that as we are true to him and follow his gospel and his commandments, the love and joy that we will feel in that moment will be like this scene times infinity. So while you may not be perfect just yet, you are perfectly loved by a Heavenly Father who has sacrificed everything to get you back home. And in the meantime, while we endure our earthly training montage, let us remember why we are truly here, to bloom in adversity. And let us also remember that through our obedience and with Christ's help, we will become the hero that he knows we are destined to be. And that is pretty cool.